I did try to start tracking my token buys because I wanted to know how much gold I was essentially bleeding that way. Didn't work out too well. Storm scale is always so good for weapons. Another big mailbox, probably gonna. Let's do it, guys. 30 days to a token should be here now, unless the price has gone up. I think it was one. We have another 50 gold here. Actually, we have a little bit more than 50 gold. Okay. Are we gonna do it? Are we gonna do it? Yep. We did it. Where's the screenshot tool? Got a snippet. Day 20. Million gold. It was definitely regularly medium and higher. Oh, nice. You don't need to sell a lot of items when you sell them for 500k. That feels good. Holy. I wonder what type of item this was. Let's take a look. Expenses. Seller's ritual. It's 30k profit. At least I get it back. It's better. Less than 10% profit margin, actually, which is honestly pretty bad. But we sell it. We get it back. We get it back, guys. All right, this is an interesting one. I think I spent some good amount of gold on this realm. Holy shit. Well, that's a sale. That's the sale right there. 962,000 gold off of one item. Oof. That feels really good. That feels. Oh, yeah. There. If I turn on the volume here, it should be sup guys. So you can see I am in Silithus. Another shard, yeah, probably. So we're killing bugs. 12 shards so far today. I was gonna open up my my banker account here. Oh, and I gotta fix this. I gotta get a. Let's see, is it here? Mouse wheeled up. Alright, and then put this here, and this here. Now I have a mouse wheel macro for tagging. This is much chiller than having to click. Not taking any chances. I don't have all these timers down, so I'm not sure where the next one's gonna spawn. I think it might be here. Who knows? Alright, so we have a lot of solid stone ready to go on my engineer. So that's very nice. Can we get all this? Cool. Craft all. 10 minutes of crafting, holy shit. I'm not sure what the timer is on this spawn. I do think Fat Dragon has it covered. I'm just gonna pull this over to the other screen for a while. So that's it. Now up to the top spawn point. And now we just scroll the mouse wheel. I can just do like very. Got this spawn down pat. Oh, let's turn on the I gotta go do a little drive-by water collection. have to I think I'm gonna make it just back in time for the worker spawn. Gonna make it back in time. Even on my casual level 60, no not level 60, 60% mount. Made it back to the spawn point just in time. Thank you for the follow, Neon Penguin. Really appreciate it. I feel like I'm not like, I've been more efficient before. Where are my fragments? They're not on the regular space. Wait. Twenty fragments. Full control on the spawn. No one even trying to contest me. No one even trying. Full control, full control. Looks like we might just have like forced everyone out of this cave, that's nice. I'm almost done with my 10-minute crafting queue for solid stone. Hordes are coming, so time for some world PvP. I'm gonna LARP as apes. Time for world PvP. Well, they got wiped. That was very effective. That was nice. Slaughtered them. And now we can craft another 7 minutes worth of supper charges right here. I still probably have more stuff. Farmer Jane. I'm just gonna pay. Right, so they have this. Who pretend to? This is my spot. Oh, there's one here. There's a spawn. Starting to get some real organization on our Scarlet Garden. Well, this pawn is mine now. Nice. Might have to fear this one a little bit. Easy kill, easy life. I have no idea what these guys are even doing here. They're just AFK, not even properly contesting any of the spawns. Just riding around, not getting much done. I sold all my I have like a hyper industrialized production line for separate charges now, and they still sell instantly. Let's see, options, timers, can you make one? I don't know if this works. Oh, yeah, now, there it is. Get off. Mm. Team best. Can I get out of combat? Idiotic void walker. Alright, back to bugs. I lost my timer now, so. Farmer, no, Farmer Jane is from Sketchy. She's the only one. Oh, there's one other. So I guess they're just farming for. Send two lazy gold, so let's mail over my separate charges. Easy kill. Get away. Get away. Now I need to get some oh, there's one. They lost it? Did they lose it? How far did they kite it? It's not close enough at all. Very easy. Time to steal aggro from my pet tank. It does essentially nothing. Log my my banker. Everyone online in Silithus, that's a strong. Finally some real strength. So that's pretty nice. 522 gold. I sold a ton of separate charges, an absolute ton of them. Some dream dust that I'm flipping. Free action potions. That's a very good mix of stuff. I was just guessing that this was about to spawn and timed my macro to perfection. Very good. I feel like searing pains are better because you have a more of a chance of getting them off without getting interrupted. Damage interrupts are extremely annoying. Wow. Another 191. So that's 700 gold. Oh, I forgot to start my timer. So I'm up to 4k again. Oh, I'm not going to make it to this one. No. Can't mount on this terrain, so that means I'm screwed. Come back. How much chitin do I have? Where's my chitin? There it is. 33. Easy. We control the tags here. 36. Wait. Is this a Field Marshal Red Paladin? Oh yes, I got that question. Didn't you ask that on Discord? Was it somewhere else? I don't remember the math on Savage Coins. Savage Plots, I think it's about 50 gold. Let me look that up. That's the wrong one. I'll take a quick look at that. I forgot to reset my timer on the upstairs one. Alright, let's see. Sold by 25 primal spirits. That's a little bit expensive. Primal spirit sold by, let's see. So that's gonna be 5 herbs. And about 50 gold, so that's about 2 gold per. I think Cards of Omens are worth a little bit more than that per herb. I don't remember the math on those, so I'll have to look up my own guide. Oh, never mind. Savage Blood is a lot better. Savage Blood is better. Assuming you can get the Primal Spirits. It looks like it's about... Oh, wait. No, wait. Never mind. I'm drunk. It's 5 per... Yeah, Cards of Omens are much more profitable. That's the right way. So for the Savage Blood, you're looking at 25 Primal Spirits, which is 5 herbs each. So that's 75 herbs for 50 gold. So I mean, each herb is worth about 0.6 or 66 silver. But if you turn them into Cards of Omens, they're worth about 1 gold per herb, a little bit more than that. So Cards of Omens, much better. Savage Bloods are only profitable if you're buying your herbs at 50 silver or below. I was miscalculating there for a second. But yeah. I don't know if I have the timer down on this guy. I'm not really getting any other spawns than this one though, at this position. Then you just have to have a timer on the top one and just be down in the caves. I did that one of the other days. Oh, it's up. God damn it. No! How can I fall off? Almost missed that one. Would have been awkward. Luckily there was... Now I can cancel all my auctions. That's one thing that's actually very annoying with the auction house throttle on retail right now. But you can't like... You can't cancel short duration auctions. It's incredibly annoying. Three fragments, very nice. Need to get a spawn timer on this. Rank 14 är rätt av den. Rank, imagine grinding rank 14 on a red paladin in classic. I have to say that's a little bit interesting. Like, you're willing to dedicate like your entire life to WoW for a period of at least 1.5 months. And you're doing it to gear out like literally the worst spec in the game. I guess he probably like did the grind as, might have done the grind as a healer. Maybe he's even a healer in raids and just like memeing in his in his ret gear while his open world farming. That is very popular. Possible. Oh, that was the wrong direction to Alteran. Where Where is he? Hvor jeg bak her kommer til dere så jeg kan sammen med den katten. Moria, du må komme tilbake og klikke. Hvor mye rep og hvor mye fragments er det du har bak her? Mm-hmm. Og hvor mange fragments har du? Totalt? Hey, Jayco. Jeg har laget et raskt Google-sheet, så det ser ut som vi mangler 19.000 fragments. Eller 18.700. Ja. We're gonna farm these until we need 18,700 more fragments for our guy to get finish the rep grind. So probably we're gonna be farming until Saturday. Our goal is to bak deg, Moria. Moria, bak deg. Spawn. Nei, vi mistet den, ja. Oh, come on. We're not fighting that guy. So hopefully we'll be done on Saturday. Og så gir meg en summon på Rogan, så tar jeg og sjekker om hvor mye hordes det er i Regal. Vi er litt for mange til begynner å nærme oss å være for mange til Arsi egentlig. Jeg har i hvert fall helt ræl spot. Right, let's go scouting. Huh? This is one hell of a grind. Kolla nu, det är Band Together och blaster oss ut då. Men nej, visst det är det. Wait. The time 0.9. Yeah. Oh, I'm in combat. Undertune, that's one of the bigger guilds in this realm. They seem to be getting most of the kills, but there aren't that many people around here. No hordes yet. Sorry, are here actually. Det er som sorry klarer å holde Vesthulen i hvert fall mot hordene her nede. Ja, men det blir PvP mot, ser det ut som. Det er masse lik her. Skal se, sjekke de to andre også. Looks like there are too many hordes to take on. Seralon. Who's that? That's not someone in the guild. Merely a setback. Not really. Alright, so there are 4 or 5 people. Reverse disaster. 3. I have a level 1 hunter here. Or no. There are people here. Not an insane amount. We could probably clear them out. Not sure we could hold it afterwards, though. That's the bigger problem. Alright, looks like I'm gonna get out. I got past the two guys at least, even while jumping straight over him. Which always feels crazy because you know that they have spy and they're gonna be looking for you. I'm gonna check Sora as well. Altså, jeg tror vi kunne sikkert tatt oss Tula, men jeg tror det mange nok har klart det, jeg har klart å jage oss ut igjen. Then I'm just gonna log out and log on my my warlock again. Nei, den sjekket jeg ikke, den har jeg tenkt noe om. Diff to Prev, what's this? Evo 11 over D11. Bare følg meg, du tar meg igjen. Jeg vil ha Warlock Mountain. Jeg er i hvert fall lat til å gjøre questen. Altså, det er jo litt pinlig å ha 4000 gull og ikke ha Epic Mount på alten sin, det er jeg enig i. Ja, det. Og Bloodwine. Må leve farlig. Siste oppdatering klokka 6 i dag, så går det ikke superfort med War Effort. Det er minst... det er en del dager til de er ferdige med å levere. Nei, det tviler jeg på at går. Siden klokka 9 i dag, eller fra 9 til 6 i dag, så klarte jeg å levere inn 3000 copper bars. Det gjenstår fortsatt 70.000. Ja, men det er bare fra 9 til 6 da, så det er jo 9 timer, men... We're actually getting some okay spawns here. Easy kill. These are nice. Tror det er bedre enn det jeg drev med før. Føles sånn. So many spawns. I think it's not the best class for this. Litt usikker på om vi får nok spons. Nå har jeg Da var det mye hordes. My pet's about to die. I should probably just like resummon one. I was gonna run over. Come on, die, you tortured sentinel. Gonna steal aggro here. Easy kill. I guess this is the nice spot to farm for fragments, because you get a lot of incidental gold from doing this. Alright. So now I'm on my own for a while. I have to pull slowly. Can be very annoying. Det er folk som ikke har noe bedre å gjøre, så er det mobs å drepe her. lot of mobs here. Not quite sure how much I'm getting in terms of fragments per hour. Sure, I'm getting a lot of. I am getting a lot of. A lot of rune cloth that I should turn into bandages so I can just use them. This has to be a pretty... you do need a healer though. I'm taking a lot of damage here. I should really be Shadow Mastery, Demonic Sacrifice for this. Maybe I should even just Demonic Sacrifice my Warlock, my Voidwalk, regardless. Oh, he resisted the Shadow Bolt. Oh, that's annoying. This food gives so little. It's just as bad as the vendor food. Very little regen, not even close to like getting full HP. Very annoying. Extremely annoying. But that is, it is what it is. Oh well. We're gonna check my BFA auctions pretty soon. I wonder if you're better off just like using Shadow Bolt. I think this is probably the best. Something like this. Immolate, Shadow Bolt, Searing Pains. En shaman her I Southwind, hva tror han gjør? Han var rett utenfor døra. So much. Let's kill off the druid. Right, so let's get going with BFA auctions on the side here. All the rest of the guys are getting to world PvP, and I'm stuck here killing non-elites. Tuned in just right? Oh, I can't guarantee that. If you want to see me repost BFA auctions, then you turn in just at the right time. Since we'll be doing that, well, probably not reposting, just collecting my sales. Because I don't think my auctions have expired, and I'm not gonna cancel them manually. I've done that before, I'm not gonna do that again. Here, then we wow, he really survived that. I thought he was for sure going to die to the dots, so I just ignored him, but apparently not. Don't think it's expired, but let's see. Oh, it has actually. No big boy sales on Stormscale, but something at least. Just gotta prepare my I actually have time to repost everything. Wait, I actually zoomed in on like one of the flies here, so it looked like it was a mob coming in from behind. That was hilarious. Easy kills. Easy kills. But I should be a better spec. My current spec is not really optimized for this kind of stuff. Reposted. Storm scale done. Let's see how much gold we have here. 4199. Pretty good. Ravencrest, let's go. Getting everything. Let's hope I have some material sales. On Ravencrest I've been doing materials only. Another very small box, very small. Shade of Amber Moon. Who cares about that? Let's just kill druids. I don't think Curse of Agony is worth it. They die too quickly. Just Immolate and Shadow Bolts. Easy kills. Another drone. Come on. I don't want to tank this guy. Oh, that was a nice pour. Nice crit. Come on, these healer mobs, very annoying. Oh, we got them both. Have to eat constantly doing this stuff. Pattern Felcloth shoulders already known, huh? But yeah, as I was saying, I completely forgot about this Ravencrest. 15-20, very little. Very small scale BOE our material sales today. So I'm gonna rip in peace. Right. He's healing himself, lol. That's very stereotypical. Tortured Sentinel. Let's pull this guy down. This should be an easy pull to kill. Guess I should at least run away from the guy who's entangled. Oh god. Can we get... God damn it, these casters, man, these healers. Five Archie drones, holy shit. This is almost intense. Flipping 5k, alright, so now we can write down how much gold I have on RavenQuest right now. Nothing impressive. It'll be interesting to see how slow it is to make it back. Another round of eating. Let's go to Sylvanas. I wonder if stuff has expired here. Scroll of Strength, yeah, I don't need that. Husk Fragment. Good stuff. Very good stuff. Turn over to the mailbox here. Oh, everything has expired. Nice, I get to repost everything then. But I get to repost on all of my realms. Guess I posted early. Let's go post. Nothing on the first page, but that's normal, essentially. Don't be so disappointed. No. Hey, Jack, how's it going? No fragment. Even more bugs. The bugs never stop. Never stop. Yeah. You need place to sort your stuff after cleaning out your auction house. Oh, yeah. Linking. Good luck. Let's hope you don't lose too much value. Let's see what we got on the second page here. Oh wow. Big boy mailbox. 333k, nice. Very nice. On Sylvanas as well. No. BFA 2020. Very nice. Very nice. Total BO 333,670. Yeah, that's a nice one. It's a nice one. I just have to pull some more. When farming this spot, you should so be... Well, if you're gonna get connected, then you're probably gonna end up essentially losing a lot of gold. Because items that you have previously purchased will just be worth much less. I don't think... I don't quite feel this. Southwind Village. Might just be the wrong class or wrong spec. To be honest, probably would have been better off doing this on my rogue. Wow. This bank thanks me. Is that any of you guys? I'm not sure I quite agree with that, Cranston. Like, I think most people just play on one server. I mean, that's the normal way to play the game. But then again, like, playing the game for primarily for the economy is probably not the normal way to play the game. And those are the ones who are really going to care about losing value by their stuff being worth less after a link. If you're just playing normally, you'll probably just be like, oh, cool, I got flasks for half price. That's going to be so nice for raid nights. These post scans are so slow. 30, 47, 315. Good afternoon, Humble. Humble Pie, I should say. Yeah, I think that I need to get like a mouse bungee or something. My mouse cord is very annoyingly placed. Skal vi komme tilbake fra Southwind da? Det høres sånn ut. What Jack? I don't remember what I just said. A mouse bungee? Another BOE? A smaller scale one? Or was it the Norwegian? We gotta go help the other guys. There are hordes coming. So we gotta slam them back to whence they came. Or whatever. 45097. Oh, come on. Instant charge days. That's some annoying stuff. Alright. 2609235. Get ready for some easy kill. Easy kill. crap. Couldn't make it. Couldn't make it. Check out Lacey here. I went away from the mic. Oh yeah. Sorry about that. Är det någon som har pullat sig när den håller? Let's see what we get on Twilight Summer. Good start, good start. About 15k in sales, it looked like. We'll take a closer look. But I gotta start the... More PvP. Yeah. I have about 4,000 gold in Classic, so I'm not like insanely rich. I just end up spending it whenever I come to about 4,000 gold. So that's where I'm at. I haven't really bought anything super expensive either, but I have like splurged on consumables and enchants and stuff like that. At least on my main. There are loads of people who are richer than me in Classic. Mostly the people who just farm a lot. What? 15k? Not bad. Bunch of flasks and two pets. I'm pretty much guaranteed to be losing money on those. Another. This has not been as like a hyper effective day for me at all. Sørget for å skaffe lute i hvert fall. Come on. Time for some more world PvP. We've been fighting these guys a lot of times. Easy kill. They keep dying. They keep pushing us and they keep dying. That's fun. But we're done on Twilight's Hammer, so let's see. For 4.7 million. Next round. Next round. I'm gonna take a chance at killing this. And if I know there are a lot of hordes around. Yeah. Wow. That was effective. He dispelled my demon armor. $141k, another BOE, another big boy BOE. I'm just gonna try to get away. I don't think I can because I'm on a slow mount. And rogues are basically corpse camp now. 141k. Thank you. Which cave is he in? And are these stuck? Alright, so let's now we're gonna kill more hordes. This is fun. We're not getting carapaces like this, but it's fun. Det kommer flere fra i døra. Bare tre da. Well, they're getting crushed. So now let's go repost again. Looking at some really good POE cells today. Right, reposting here. Reposting is so slow. A little too many hordies here now. So they're just gonna like take the cave. So this is looking like a really good day. Chatar is done. How am I looking today? It's like 500k? 555 in sales so far on the realms I've checked. So that's very good. That's very good. Yeah, my hourly rate today has been horrendous. Wow, I must have known that was coming. That was quick. Thank you. Nothing here. Nothing. That's a little sad. I'm getting tired, so we're gonna finish reposting and then I'm gonna call it a night as well. Morning tea and Portento and people from the other guilds. So, any of you guys in the chat who reads the Classic WoW subreddit? It's been hilarious lately, because at least for me, because there's been a lot of memeing on our Classic realm, because Alliance and Horde are really, really mad at each other. That was an easy kill. Usually about 30% in profit, Board Fiend. So that's about firing up the hatred they want to take out of life. I don't know. But because the thing is that Alliance on Sandalar Tribe has... we outnumber the Hordes about 60 to 40%, something like that. And Alliance has a couple of very sweaty, very try-hard guilds. Or at one in particular, Praxis, which is like by far the top guild on the realm. And apparently, like, they were either the Horde expected, or some of them may have trash talked, I don't know. So they expected that they would do everything for the war effort, because you have to turn in so many materials for the war effort right now. I haven't talked about the Galeox things yet, Metket. But yeah, I mean, I'm not surprised at all. I've suspected for a long while that that someone involved in the boosting communities is making money. I think it's most likely at the end of the day, like, the top guys at management, they're gonna end up with so much gold. What are they gonna do with all that gold? And with how professional they are, it just seems like an enterprise, like some form of corporation level stuff. So I expect that they're making money off of that much effort. I expect also that most of the boosters probably had nothing to do with it. I haven't followed it much. I just read that the people have been banned for real money trading. I expect that most of there are people in all of the big boosting communities who do real money trading. Galawix was by far the biggest boosting community for retail, the oldest and biggest. I mean, I haven't read like any of the details, but I think it's more likely that it's the people who run the community than anyone else doing real money trading, and they're probably like striking very hard down on boosters doing that kind of stuff to make sure that they can keep the gravy train going. At least that's my cynical view. Alright. How the hell do they have 4.6 billion gold on just four accounts? It's impressive. But yeah, they make an insane amount of gold. The boosting communities. And boosters. So if you're good at PvE, like, boosting is a legitimate way to make gold. Although back in the day it used to be like whatever top guild on your realm would boost the latest instance. Now it's just like huge faceless communities that are run essentially as talent tag from Horde Mage, I think. Yep. Well, suck it, Mr. Horde Mage. There's constant giant inflation. I mean, of course Blizzard are gonna know about them. Have I forgotten to turn down my prices on here? I might have. Yeah, I should be using the fire sale operation. No wonder I'm not getting too much sales here. I'm sure that the boost community accounts, like the main accounts there, are the accounts that have by far the most gold going in and out in the game. So of course, if you're trading large amounts of gold, you're gonna get flagged, and they're gonna look at your account in depth to, because then you're gonna be like, okay, this is a potential real money trading account. Thank you for the follows, Angel, Dwarfbeer20. Really appreciate it. Giant crash. What are you thinking about? Inflation wouldn't cause a crash. Inflation is just constant prices going upwards. Let's go see my ask sound. We'll see. I mean, yeah, one gold is all nothing. It's like what one copper used to be. But gold is super valuable. Rogue Pamai. I mean, gold is like, okay, one gold, I agree, one gold doesn't have too much value. But gold is very, very useful and valuable as a... I mean, it's as valuable as it's ever been because of the token, and you can turn it into actual like games and game time and stuff like that. Um, We already had massive deflation in at the beginning of BFA because they turned off the crazy gold gain methods from Legion that were generating a lot of gold. So I doubt they'll do another deflationary expansion. I think it's going to be similar to BFA. Yeah, and most people had to work really hard to get their Brutosaurs. I don't think this is comparable to like 80k from Pandaria at all. Getting 5 million in BFA is much harder than getting 80,000 gold in Pandaria. It's my opinion, at least. I remember when I was doing gold making in Pandaria, I had a pretty good empire there, actually. And I actually have some chat logs about like being really happy after a 36k mailbox or day of sales on a reset day. Mostly doing jewel crafting. I wasn't doing every profession even. So 80,000 gold in Pandaria, that's not a lot of gold. That's equivalent to like maybe 500,000 BFA gold, maybe. So that's like two different stratospheres of, or two completely different levels of Vanity Mount. You'd be better off comparing to like the Spider Mount from Legion that was 2 million, and then the new expensive Ender Mount in BFA was 5. That indicates how much inflation we had in Legion. In Legion, Legion was just absolutely crazy when it comes to inflation. Now I opened the wrong one. Oh, I am getting. I'm actually finished with my auctionings now. Or auctionings. What the hell? No, I don't have the beta. Yeah. Ironically, the Brutosaur is much more useful for people who aren't hardcore gold makers. Like, if you're rich enough to get the Bruto and you did it with the auction house, then you probably don't need the Bruto because you're better off just using a bank alt. It's more efficient. More time efficient than keeping everything on your main. At least that's my opinion. But the Brutosaur is going to be amazing early expansion, obviously. When you want to get stuff as fast as humanly possible onto the auction house, unless you have two accounts. Since I'm two account guy, I can just instantly move my stuff over to my banker by mailing and post while playing. But for non-pay to win players, yeah, the Bulbasaur. I think it's cool. Like, I think Blizzard might have said it was a mistake. I think I don't know. Where's our hopeful? There he is. No. Yeah, there he is. So now I'm just gonna ride up to Cenarion Hold and just about call it a night. Because I'm my eyes are sliding shut essentially. So yeah, time to go to bed. So I hope you all had fun, even though we're just squashing bugs. It'll probably just be squashing bugs next stream as well on Thursday. Yeah, it's gonna be, I think it's cool that you have the limited factor as well. It's gonna be like, this guy was rich or managed to be good at gold making during BFA. The biggest issue is that you have to keep increasing the price heavily, because otherwise if they add another 5 million gold mount, there are gonna be so many people who already just have 5 million lying around, they'll just buy it day one. So then it doesn't like show an achievement at any specific point in time. And if it's not going to show an achievement at a specific point in time, then you might as well like not time limit it. Because then the time limit doesn't matter as much. Gonna have to get that. So let's just take a quick look at the auction house. Well, that's not really the loss in value, because the price going up, yeah, of course, it's going to be harder to get the vanity mount, but it's probably going to be balanced by ease of obtaining gold. And by the fact that every day, literally every day on average, people generate way more gold than they spend by just going out into the world and killing mobs and looting them and vendoring the crap they get and stuff like that. Which is always going to happen. The prices are always going to trend upwards, always. Just due to the fact that gold is always being generated, always. Is this stuff still for sale? Oh, there's one for 300. This is more reasonable. I'm considering this for my warlock. Be a pretty nice upgrade. Probably not, though. So the Silithid stuff is still expensive. Might have to buy some, we'll see. So we'll see what the future brings. I don't think they haven't mentioned anything like massive gold sink stuff from Shadowlands yet, have they? Nothing that I've seen yet, so yeah. So we'll see, it would be interesting if we get anything, any new stretch goals. But ultimately, like, they're also gonna have to increase the stretch goals just to make people feel like there's a next level to reach. Which would eventually just make it very, very boring. But yeah. Ooh. As you can see, I clearly need to get to bed. So thank you all for stopping by. I'll be back on Thursday. Killing more mobs. Or killing more bugs. And then from Sunday on, we'll hopefully be done with the rep grind. And then I'll get to stream the Scepter of the Shifting Sand questline. And then further on, back to more regular gold-making focused content. But since we're trying for Scarab Lord and we're a casual dad gamer style guild, we have to put in the hours that I can to help out. Or I want to. I don't have to, but I really want to, because it would be really cool to get the Scarab Lord in our guild. So my warlock is in Silithus and working hard. Make sure you're following, and hopefully I'll see you on Thursday. Good night, guys.